Hello everyone, my name is Faisal. I will be showing you how to install Northwind and the Pubs database in SQL Express 2014. A quick outline for this presentation, we'll be downloading the database package and then I'll show you how to install Northwind first and then subsequently install Pubs. So what I've done is I've already opened up the Microsoft Download Center where you can see where you can download the Northwind and the Pubs sample database for SQL Server 2000. And this is not for SQL Server Express 2014, and we will generate some exceptions while we're trying to install it, but I'll show you how to manage those exceptions. The link for this download is also available in the description. I've already downloaded the package. You can see that it's an .msi file, which is the Windows installer package. Once you run this package file, what you will get at the end of it is, I'm not going to run it because I've already run it. Yes, close. What you'll get is this SQL Server 2000 sample databases folder. Now this sample databases folder has both the databases in there. It's got the Northwind database in there and the Pubs database in there. So now from here you can open your SQL Server instance, and what I'll do is I'll go into File, Browse to Open, and Browse to File again. And then you are going to go and locate where you have the SQL Server 2000 samples databases folder. And when you go into that folder to install the Northwind, which is what we're going to do first, you just open the SQL file that is in that folder. Once the SQL file is open, just execute this file. These are the exceptions that I was talking about, the SPDB option. What we're going to do is, this is not applicable in the 2014 Express Edition and was valid for the 2000 SQL Server. So what I'll do is I'm going to do a Control F, quickly look for the SPDB option. And as expected, I found two lines of code related to that. What I'll do is I'll comment them out and I will execute the code again. Now this time it's run successfully. What I'll do is I'll come back to my database instance and I will refresh it. Once refreshed, you'll see that the Northwind database has appeared there. You can look at the tables. And let's just quickly look at the categories table in there, and you can see that the categories table is there, the views are there, and everything's worked as expected. I don't want to save that. Let's go on now and install the Pubs database. It's a similar idea. We'll go to File, we'll browse to Open, and then we'll browse to File again. Because it was last opened, the SQL Server 2000 samples database was the last open folder. We are back there again. I don't want to install using the MDF file formats because it's going to give you the same error, and you'll have to come in and comment out those SPDB options. So what I'll do is I'll just go to the SQL file for the Pubs database as well, and I'll open that and execute it. Again, similar error is what I see in message 2812, level 16 and line 56, but what I'll do is I'll just quickly look for it, SPDB option. And once I've found this, I will comment it out and execute it again. So the query has executed successfully is the message that I get. What I'll do is I'll refresh the instance over here, and once refreshed, I will see the Pubs database. I'll quickly check if I am getting if it did install successfully. So what I'll do is select the top 1,000 rows, and there you go. That's the authors table in the Pubs database.